This is the Rebel Call Channel. Welcome to today's show. Many of you may have seen the video I did a few months ago, even though I'm a brand new YouTuber, about the movie Civil War. And now that the movie has been released, I need to talk about it again because all of the stories out there, this is exactly how mind control works through predictive programming. All of the stories out there that have come out since this movie has come out say things like this: the eerie parallels between Civil War and this real-life revolution, right? Or Alex Garland, Civil War is an explosive warning against a Trump takeover. These are the types of stories that have come out since the movie has come out. I'm telling you that, wow, it's really weird parallels. The movie kind of really weirdly paralleled the real world. That's because they're programming you. That's because this isn't an eerie parallel. The movie is programming. That's what this stuff is, because everything that's happening in the real world right now isn't really real. It's manufactured. So we can call it real life. We can say things like real life revolution. Talking about Trump and the war, the takeover, the warning against a potential civil war that's coming. It's going to be explosive. Well, that's only because they're the ones who have fueled the civil war. See, what they do is they formulate the news because they control the news, and they give you a blurred, manufactured perspective of what's going on in the world. Thus, all this division. You know, there have been Democrat and Republican parties for a long time. Now, your vote hasn't counted for a long time. But 30 years ago, 20 years ago, nobody cared what other people did as far as voting goes. They go, oh, who are you going to vote for? Who are you going to vote for? So, all right, whatever. Because when the person ended up getting put in a position of power, it didn't really ever affect their day-to-day life. Right? Yeah, their taxes may have gone up here. Inflation may have happened there. But overall, your quality of life and your mental health was never affected by what person was put in the White House until now. So for people out there who are young, you should start realizing that it's never been like this before. And the alt-right media and the communist media are manipulating you into choosing a side. They're not giving you the option to not participate. They're making you choose a side because, of course, they want you to feel like you're responsible for the rigged outcome of the coming election, and of course, the coming manufactured civil war, because they are dividing us into blue and red states, and that's what this video is about. I'm going to show you some of the latest programming that's out there. But first, for anybody out there that missed it, let me give you just a little clip of the trailer. And of course, the trailer mimics real life, because just like the movie is written with a script, so is everything that's happening around us right now with the Democrats and the Republicans. The fake leaders in power, the fake president, the fake Donald Trump, former president, these people are all manipulating you into political parties. They are the ones dividing you through manufactured news, like the story with Trump right now being on trial. Even if he goes to jail, he'll be out in time for the election. This is to build momentum, build support, and to get people to not actually start a revolution against what these people are doing. Because if the people realize that these politicians were forming this division amongst civilians, if they realize that the vote didn't even count, then everybody would put all their differences aside and these people will be gone. But as long as you stay in this simulated reality, as long as you stay in this left-right paradigm, you are playing right into their hands. Here is a clip from the trailer, Civil War, which just came out.
19 states have seceded.
The United States Army ramps up activity.
The White House issued warnings to the Western forces as well as the Florida Alliance.
The future president assures the uprising will be dealt with swiftly.
I'm just aware there's like a pretty huge civil war going on.
Citizens of America, the so-called Western forces of Texas and California have suffered a very great defeat at the hands of the United States military.
Mr. President, do you regret the use of airstrikes against American citizens?
They shoot generals on sight in the Capitol. Every instinct in me says this is death.
What? Don't do that. But here we are.
Some kind of misunderstanding here.
What?
We're American, okay?
Okay. What kind of American are you?
You don't know.
Western forces will reach the White House on July 4th.
Run, run, run!
One nation,
under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. God bless America.
So does that look eerily similar to what's going on?
Yeah,
that's because, just like I said earlier, the movie was written with the script, and that same script is the script that they're using in our everyday lives. You see, movies actually have more truth to them because they use predictive programming. So they show you in movies what's going to happen before it happens, which, of course, is a form of magic as well. They show us this ahead of time, and they also program how you respond to it. They program you in a movie like this into being, well, this is your political affiliation, this is how you're supposed to respond, right? Of course, the movie ends with the President of the United States hiding under his desk, and of course, the President of the United States kind of taking on a Trump-like appearance or Trump-like persona in the film, and of course, the President ends up getting killed. This is all big manufacturing. So, let's take a look at some of the stories out there that aren't related to the movie, which have everything to do with it. Now, remember, I showed you this map that they released before the movie came out. This is not a blueprint. This is not a blueprint of how it's going to look. But, of course, it at least gives you a visual so you can realize that it's going to be a new map in the United States. Now, I'm not saying that any of this is going to be real as far as the areas, each state, what they're showing, because that's not been determined yet. But we need to watch these stories out there because then we can really tell what states are going to be blue, what states are going to be red. For example, what I covered with the chemtrail bill that's been passed in Tennessee, it shows us it's going to be a conservative state because these are luring tactics. These are tactics they're using to get people like me and you to want to move into these states. And I've warned people, and I've said it before, and I'll say it a million times, I don't care if I'm repeating myself. When you get lured into a state and they're using tactics like chemtrails, when we know these people don't care about us, we all have to be awake. Okay, because we can all see that story and say, I want to live there because I don't want to have chemicals dumped on me anymore. And I don't want these gray sky days. I'd like to see the blue sky again. It'll be wonderful, right? However, you don't think that they already know that you're going to come to those states? It's almost like they're saying, hey, come to our state. We'll give you $1 million. That's what it feels like. So do you trust these people to go to their states? Do you trust Florida to go to Florida?
What the fuck?
No. It tells me that these are states that they control with weaponized weather as well as direct energy weapons. So look,
you didn't hear what I said, did you, Tay?
Hysterical articles that are out
there. Then.
These articles, again,
I say nothing.
Subliminally, and it's subliminal because people read these articles and they don't even realize what they're trying to do to them. Let's start with this. Oh, this is the most prominent funny so I've seen them up.
Huh?
Red State is the Washington Post, by the way.
What?
Okay, this isn't just some a blogger.
What?
Okay, whatever your take is on the Washington Post.
What does that mean?
Whatever you want to call it.
Like this.
It gets a lot of views. It's considered a credible news outlet, at least to the Dems out there. Okay? Look at this. So obviously, they know Dems are going to read this. This is how they're marketing it to the Dems, right? Red states threaten librarians with prison as blue states work to protect them. This article literally talks about how, apparently, in red states, not only are librarians being threatened, if that's not funny enough and hard enough to believe because it's not true, they're actually threatening prison to a librarian. So what does this do? Well, of course, it ties into this whole narrative. You know, this shows you how warped it is, that each side only sees through their own lenses, right? And they can't see that both sides have the exact same viewpoint of the other. Right.
$36 billion global industry.
Through their own lenses, right? And they can't see that both sides have the exact same viewpoint of the other, right? Anybody who's conservative can look at Biden, these guys, and see what's going on and feel like it's a tyrannical government, a communist tyrannical government that is doing what they want. There's no rules for Democrats, that the CIA, the FBI, the IRS is coming after Republicans, right? That's the viewpoint conservatives have. The other side look at it, and they think if Trump wins, it's a fascist society. He's going to get rid of gays. There's going to be no more right to Planned Parenthood. And they see it's the same perspective through each side. It's extremism on either side, right? The other stuff that we see is the same thing, too, with the books, right? We see how they are trying to put books in public schools about what? The most ridiculous topics you can imagine, right? They're putting trans in the books. They're putting racial undertones in the books, telling everyone they're racist. They know the response of this. It's extreme, right? The Democratic Party knows that conservatives are not going to allow their kids to go into these schools. The same is on the flip side. This story
and we hear about Bible burning and banning of books. You know, they try to tie this into, like, a book in the library. Like, oh, well, you know, they're going to try to ban all books. You're not allowed to read books. So both sides are being gaslit with this book stuff. And what can be said and can't be said, just like they're being gaslit with this tyrannical narrative from both political regimes, even though all of them are tyrannical. And conservatives can't see how Trump is a tyrant, too. They only see Biden as one. When Trump was in power, we all lost our right to free speech. So, this article says, Sandley, a leader of the Connecticut Library Association, heads to work these days torn between hope and fear. She's encouraged because legislators in her state proposed a bill this year making it harder for school boards to ban library books. But she's fearful because Connecticut, which is lit, like America, is seeing a sustained surge in book challenges, and she wonders if objectors will see the legislation as a reason to file for complaints. And ultimately about the book ban, if anyone out there doesn't know where this is headed, this is all to ban Bibles. Ultimately, it's going to be looked at as the ultimate book of hate speech and violence. We're not there yet, but 20 years from now, younger generations are only going to know the Bible as this wicked, horrible, harmful book. Okay, that's what they're working towards. If these legislations will allow that eventually to be the world that we live in. So, the librarian says, I'd like to be optimistic, but I've been in my position for a few years. I don't know. It really feels like it's been forever, and I'm worried the book banners are just going to be emboldened. The bill in Connecticut, pending before an education committee, is one of a range of measures advancing nationwide that seek to do things like prohibit book bans or prevent the harassment of school public librarians. I mean, who's going to the library except the librarians picking out the books? That's where I'm going to start this whole conversation, right? Is anyone going to the library and you think it's just the librarian that has to say of what books are in the library? Like, every book in there is like her own personal, you know, catalog of books, right? So if it's like a trans librarian, it's only her books. There's no books in there. Like, you won't find, like, for example, 1984, or you won't find, like, To Kill a Mockingbird. It'll only be, I mean, really? Of course, that's the idea they want you to have. This is what they're building in people's minds, right? They're literally building in people's minds that people are just lighting books on fire, no matter what the book is about, et cetera, et cetera. And ultimately, the government wants to destroy all books. They're going to only be books that they allow you to read. Your state can know books. They really are the public school books. But it's only going to get more extreme than the stuff that we've seen in the past that have political undertones to them. Okay, so this goes on to say, the library-friendly measures are being outplaced by bills in mostly red states that aim to restrict which book libraries can offer and threaten librarians with prison or thousands in fines for handing out obscene or harmful titles. At least 27 states are considering 100 bills this year, three of which have become law of the post. That adds to nearly a dozen similar measures enacted over the last 3 years across Kansas State. So, it's amazing that people don't notice how gaslit the news is. So, this is what happens. Falling apart, right? This is what they're focusing on. Students are making sure that they have book bans in place. Because why? Because they know that this will keep liberals out of the state, right? And it's going to make force them into migrating to other states. They're doing it in every state now. Every state is now adopting and identifying with a political party. This is dual coming. They want to control all of us. Reason why it's a civil war, per se. I'm not saying there's going to be a civil war with guns or whatever else. But if this gets divided state by state the way that I think, in the coming decade or so, okay? Because this election is going to be the beginning of those dominoes fall. Because, like I said, even though we come in the election, it doesn't matter how this is rigged. Do I know how it's rigged? No. Do I believe Trump will be the rigged winner? Probably. But again, it works either way. Because if Biden's the rigged winner, Trump followers won't believe it either, and they'll have enough and they'll separate. Either side will. Because either they're making it to the point where neither side can live with the opposite party in charge, or living among the opposite people, which is why you're going to see another rollout of magic potions. That will be one of the ultimate things that people like us to possibly comply, unless, of course, we can manipulate our way around this system. But like I've been saying, with the digital ID, it's going to be, that's the way that you won't be able to manipulate really anymore, unless you're really, really clever and smart. I like to think that I am, but I'm not quite sure. If I can trust somebody to manipulate through their system without actually getting a digital ID, right? So the digital ID, of course, is going to be the big thing because the magic code is going to be tied into it. And then you say, well, how do we infiltrate and how do we navigate around it? Well, we are, right? But if they make band-aids like that again, people like me and you aren't going to be able to live in states that force that on us, are we? No, we're not. That's what's coming next. That's why that happened the way it did the first time. We talked about this on the website many times. The bills that got put in place after that are going to make things way worse the next time. And that's the point. The bills are now in place for massive quarantines, massive shutdowns, people losing their jobs, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Only in the Democratic states. That's how we can see which states are already set up to be Democratic states. And those are, some of them are already really obvious, just like some of the conservative ones, right? New York, death. California, death. Illinois, death. Right? Those are the obvious. Conservative, Texas, and Florida. Everybody knows that. That's pretty clear, right? And you might even have, like they showed in that map, some type of, they showed the Florida Alliance. That actually might be the Florida Alliance with Texas, which would be great. Now, again, there's probably going to be outlier states, which I think could potentially happen, but we'll get to that down the line. First, we need to get people to realize what they're doing. We need to get conservatives to realize that this is ultimately people who are looking forward to the election. They all think that Trump is going to win in a landslide, okay? Which makes me think that they'll put Biden back in, too, so it can work either way. But they are, all those people are convinced that Trump will win, and if he doesn't win, it's rigged, okay? And Democrats are convinced of the same thing. And both sides, with more laws that can pass, like, oh my gosh, librarians are feeling threatened in red states. Okay, well, not just obviously the librarians, which is really blue states. There's not many librarians, okay? But those types of undertones with books, with what they perceive as freedom, even though the books that they read are all communist propaganda books. Communist propaganda books about the color of your skin. I mean, it's unbelievable. See, people think it's like some law that we're advanced thinking now, and these people are really talking about equality. They're so dumb. It's incredible. And they're dumb because they're under mind control, but they're also the same people that hear of it and go, like, why they refuse to believe it. That's what gets me irritated. They refuse to believe it because they're narcissists. And they've created narcissists, and they don't want to hear anything other than what they believe in. They're not willing to change. They're not willing to accept that this is all simulated and created. Really manufactured, right? Like the old commercial I always played in my videos. The factory is your home. The product being manufactured is you. And that's exactly what's happening here. So I worry about conservatives. I worry about them. I worry about everybody. Because this shouldn't be happening. But everybody's accepting of this, and they don't really, they're seed planting. They're seed planting with movies like this, how to respond when it happens. They're seed planting with articles like this. We've never seen this before, okay? We've never seen states associated with political lines. 30 years ago, everybody would honestly wouldn't even know how somebody else voted, and nobody would care. You know, if it came up at a dinner party, you know, people were like, I don't talk politics. If it came up, it came up. And people would be like, yeah, whatever. You know, you're allowed to feel that way. It's not a big deal. Now it's like, if you disagree, I won't be your friend. I don't want to see you ever again. I don't want to hang out. And that's all been done by their mind control propaganda. No other reason other than that. They're gaslighting. They're manipulating you like a crazy ex-girlfriend or boyfriend. And ultimately, people aren't looking ahead and seeing these stories of why they're here now. They're seed planting. They're conditioning you and programming, just like that movie is programming you, which is why they call the TV, or used to call the TV and the movies, programs, because they're programming you. And eventually, when this stuff goes down the way they expect it to go down, which I believe will be this election, it'll be the next domino to fall. People go, well, I don't want to live in this world. Instead of going, wait a minute. What we should be doing right now is watching how both sides should be evaluating both sides, their own side and the other side, and saying none of them are working, because they're supposed to be our employees, literally, and we're their slaves. They're supposed to be our employees. That's what a politician is, right? But we know,